Do you want these? The percolating pectorals, huh? Do you want them?
A nice workout on a Saturday morning. So here we are on the 19th of November 2016 with the new Vlog. Although actually my daughter did mention that it's not actually Vlog, it's Vlog. Whether that's showing my age or not, I don't know. Vlog, Vlog, what's the difference? Who cares? But anyway, after all your comments from the last vlog we did, which was on Thursday, one of the comments was to have a look around the workshop and see what's what. So I'm just going to go freshen up and we'll have just a quick rundown of the workshop, because what we've got to remember here is, if we went into detail with everything that was in here, I mean, we could pull off easy an hour long worth video. So I'm just going to give you a quick rundown around the shop. So starting in the workshop here, we're down this end where I've got my nice little table just down here where I sort of put my models that are sort of put on one side while I'm working on another model. Always good to have a fridge, you know, keeping all your beers, your meals, your drinks and all that kind of stuff. A little bit of note about this building that I built is I built it to be soundproof, so we've got soundproof plasterboards and insulation and sort of like a nice couple of layers. On the ceiling here, you know, we've got this whole sort of acoustic membrane stuff and some soundproofing in the ceiling as well. So it just helps sort of bounce the noise around me speaking and stuff, so it doesn't sound all echoey and all that kind of stuff. It just makes it sort of sound nice, as well as it helps with, you know, heating as well, which is always good. I mean, I've sort of put enough insulation in here so that even over winter time I can have like a heater on here, like a 1000 watt lit heater on low, and it's really nice and cozy in here. So really has paid off to do that. As we move around, we have my kit collection here, which is all sorts of kits going on, as you can probably see across here and down there. Got my little treadmill as well, and we have my little turtle collection as well just down here, which I have gone off and built this sort of nice big top basking area, which you didn't see in the last vlog. But as you can see, we've got like a smoke machine, a little fountain at the back, you got the basking lights, UVB, UVA, and there somewhere down there, hopefully, as you can see, where are they gone? Oh, they're sort of hiding. There's one just up there. That's that one's Poseidon. And then as we sort of move around, we can sort of see the sort of like the behind the scenes, what you don't see on camera just here. So just quickly changing the camera angle here, here is the sort of behind the sort of scenes, what you don't see when I'm on camera. To start off with, we have, hopefully as you can see, we have our frontal cam just here with a light which basically lights up my face. We have our bird's eye view camera just here, which is always a good one to you know, get those good angles, as well as a backup camera. We've got a little monitor just here as well. This is always good to sort of blow up in real time what it is I'm filming
on our main camera just there. This is just so if I sort of go off camera, I can see very clearly with this big sort of screen here to get you back on camera. Or if I don't, I've always got my backup bird's eye view to sort of get all the action if need be. We've got our spare camera just here, just in case we want to change a certain angle or something. Nice shotgun mic, getting all the action, getting pretty much, I mean, I do like the shotgun mic. The sound does seem to come across rather nice, if you ask me. We've got a webcam, which I do honestly sort of need to sort of get that sort of up and running. Good old face mask, always need one of them, with extractor fan. Nice little table light here. I do like this one, and when people sort of ask me, you know, what sort of light should I get for my workstation, these lights, these are good. There's three sort of nice fluorescent bulbs in here. It sort of works, lights up your workstation really nicely. It's sort of got this nice arm, so you can sort of like really sort of put it in whatever position. They are a bit expensive, they're about £70-80, but in all honesty, if you want to get something cheap and good light, studio lighting, to be totally honest with you, you can pick these up sort of a lot cheaper than these lights, and they really do sort of light up your workstation rather nicely. So if you want a bit of a budget, look into studio lighting. You can really pick them up for some good prices. So moving around, we've just got another light up here. We've got the Top Gun trophy as well. You know, this is where all the names of the Top Gun best of the best of our group builds have their names on the Genesis Models Top Gun trophy. We then work our way around to the and the back wall here, where you see all the paints. I won't go into major detail here because, I mean, there's just so many paints, but, you know, you got Tamiya just up here. We've got Vallejo just over here. Those two sets of paints are really good for you beginners. And then we've got all our weathering products from Ammo, AK paints, Akan paints. When it comes to brush painting, right, when I'm actually going off and painting miniatures or any sort of brush painting, I do like to use the Citadel paints. They are my preferred brand. Just down here we've got Hanants. Those paints, okay, they're not probably the easiest to use, but they do have some good matching colors for certain aircraft. Moving along, we have a bunch of just thinners, airbrush cleaners, some glosses and stuff that are just nicely at hand, with some paints just there. If I sort of get past my chair here, I then have all my models just here on display, which pretty much 90% of what's in here is what has been filmed in Step by Steps or something like that. There's our F-15. I do have my selection of Space Marines here, which is just something I do personally on the side. Hopefully you're liking them. And then as we sort of go down, we've just got a bunch of sort of miniatures I'm sort of priming up at the bottom there. Moving across here, you know, again, we've got all our models here that which you've probably seen in video builds, all nicely on display, which I do plan on building a nice big massive display cabinet just down there. Nice custom built one for all of them to go, as well as this beast, because this beast is going to need a massive display cabinet, which would cost a lot of money to go out and buy one. So I'm just going to build a big massive one and put everything down there. So there's a HMS Victory, which by the way, people do keep on asking, what's going to go on, where's HMS Victory? I did mention it in the November Genesis model show, so go check that out and you'll find out what's going on with that. So coming to the desk area, this is what I see. Right, as you can see all nice big screen there to be able to see what's going on this camera. But we've got our airbrushes just over here. Moving down, we have a nice set of drawers. Right, and in these drawers I keep all my tools, which is really sort of helpful to sort of keep everything you know, sort of in its right place. Right, and there's loads of these drawers with loads of different tools. So if you want to sort of, you know, pause the camera and maybe sort of you can have a good look at what's in there. But as I say, I could go off and I could make a video where I show absolutely everything in detail. All this drawer is just basically glues, which is kind of absolutely mad, the amount of glues that you can get. Got sanding sticks in there. We've then got another set of drawers over this, so it's all nicely at hand. Right, let's bring out the next one. All sorts of bits and bobs in there. Ooh, nice Series 7 paintbrushes. Well recommended, those ones. A bunch of odds and sods in here. Bending, photo etch bending tools. Grass, static grass. Cotton wool buds, always a good tool. In here is all sorts of, oh, we've got all sorts of varnishes and all sorts, a nice bunch of Winsor & Newton stuff, sort of like oil thinners and all sorts of cool stuff that I haven't got around to sort of actually doing product reviews or anything on. And then there's sort of, yeah, other stuff in there. And then just up in the ceiling, just there, we've got a built-in extractor fan unit. I do intend to put another one just there. And this was sort of like the whole advantage of sort of building my own workshop was, I mean, I've got sockets absolutely everywhere. You know, the whole soundproofing thing really, really helps. Because, you know, times in the past where I've had helicopters go over or ambulances go past and then you have to sort of cut and start again, and sometimes, you know, you've got you're working on something that really is just a one take and that's it, or you're gonna have to sort of, like, you know, go back somehow or buy a whole new kit. You know, so the whole soundproofing really does help, and to be able to sort of like put these extractor fans in, also really good, because doing this as a living, I'm doing this day in day out, and I really sort of have to think about my health and sort of like the air conditions in here, because I'm constantly sort of in here. So, you know, we've got a an half decent, pretty good extractor fan just over there, which you saw, and, you know, I've put in a really sort of big sort of extractor fan. I'll probably put it on because I've also sort of put it in the ceiling. I've soundproofed it a little bit, but I do intend to soundproof it a little bit more, as well as put a second one in, and hopefully, you know, you can still sort of, you can hear it, but you can still hear me clearly. And it just really sort of nicely sucks out the air out the room. It's quite cool, actually. I try and open the door, and you really do get some suction on the door because I've just totally and utterly sealed this room in. So that is sort of like a really sort of quick look and rundown of the Genesis Models Workshop. If you're really sort of liking it, I can go off and make a full-on video totally and utterly devoted to showing the workshop, and we can really go into detail showing you, you know, so many sort of products and giving you a quick rundown of products. So it'd be almost like a big massive product review of sort of like everything in modeling. So sadly, that is it for our vlog for Saturday the 19th of November 2016. If you like it, give me a thumbs up, give me a thumbs down, subscribe, don't subscribe, but until next time, my name is Bobby Waldron, this is Genesis Models, and I hope you've enjoyed. We'll be right back.